Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Hey fish family, welcome back to Tabarak Aquatics. I am Ross. This is my fish room. And sorry guys, I haven't posted in quite a while. That's because I've been extremely busy with projects going on and home life. Well anyway, right now as I ponder on which direction I'm going to take this fish room, as far as growing the fish room and growing my channel, I'm going to go ahead and give you guys a peek today at what my maintenance is like and how I tackle all these water changes and you know, my maintenance. All right, thank you for joining me. Okay, y'all, as you can see, this is quite embarrassing. This fish room is a mess. Like I said, I've been working on projects. As you can see, I've been unboxing new heaters, new pumps, new food deliveries, all kinds of stuff. But anyway, we're gonna fix this mess. All right, let's start by talking about the weapons of choice. I have this pump. Now what I do is I have this pump with this tubing, and I put this pump inside of my larger tanks, and I go ahead and drain the water out that way and make it pretty fast. And what I do is simultaneously, I go ahead and use my my Python. Let me give you guys a look at how I do it, but that's how you get it done really fast. And if I want to, what I can do is drain one tank and fill the other tank at the same time, or you know, interchangeably, but it makes it a heck of a lot easier when you have yourself a pump pumping out the water, and also using the siphon with the Python. All right, fish family, go ahead and get my pump and climb up on my step ladder and go ahead and submerge my pump down at the level where I want it to. Of course, if you don't want it too deep, don't put it all the way at the bottom. I keep mine at the bottom because I don't want the fish swimming around bumping into it. So of course, the next thing I do is I go ahead and get all the tubing, untangle it, and take the tubing outside, run it outside to the yard before I actually plug it in, or I might make a mess in the basement. Then of course, what's next is I go ahead and put my Python in the tank, close the lid down on top pump so that they can stay in place, and then I go ahead outside and hook it up to the faucet and turn it on. And then I connect the Python on the other end to this spigot. I turn it on, I open it up, create a siphon, and I wait for it. It's creating a siphon, and you can tell when it starts flowing through because it'll flow differently. All right, so there we got it. So we got a good siphon, and when I get a good siphon, I can go ahead and turn this off so I don't waste water. Before I had that pump, I would, and for the value of time, I would just have that running consistently just to drain the water faster, and I would be wasting so much water. So now I'm saving money by doing it this way with the pump inside. All right, so I have that pump inside that's drawing the water out. You see the pump, and then you see the siphon, also the you know, the Python rather, pulling the water out simultaneously at the same time. Now I have to be mindful, because down here in my sump over here where my pump is, that water is very, very low. So you have to remember that before you ruin your pump. I have two pumps in there, because one of them pumps water through my UV sterilizer. So what I have to do is unplug that pump that goes up to the tank and allow it to refill so I don't burn my pump out. All right,
so the next thing that I do is when I go over here to do these two tanks here, I go ahead and put the pump and the python in and get the siphon and getting all that water out. It gets out pretty quick that way. All right, I turn the wave maker off and I keep the two pumps going. This tank is powered by these two pent plaques, 1500s. I believe in a lot of filtration, so I keep the filtration going because I want to supply all that oxygen. So all that agitation it ensures that my fish are well oxygenated. They're stressed out enough by me playing in their tank, or cleaning their tank. But to them, I'm invading. So I try to keep them all well oxygenated, and I try to keep them as calm. Usually I cut the lights out, but I'm keeping the lights on for the purpose of y'all to see what it is that I'm doing. All right, so this is where the brilliance come in at. So I'm refilling this tank. Of course, I use the Seachem Safe when I'm water conditioner, Seachem Safe water conditioner. So like I said, on my larger tanks, I use Safe, and on my smaller tanks, I use Prime. All right, so this takes just 1/8 of a teaspoon to satisfy as far as softening this 125 to 150 gallons of water. So anyway, I'm filling this tank up right here with the python, and like I said, the genius part is that down here I am emptying this tank with the pump. So as that tank up there up top is filling, this tank right here is emptying out. So I get to, so by the time I finish emptying this out, about 40 to 50%, then the tank up here should be finished filling, and I can go ahead and pull that python down here and fill this up. So this saves me a lot of time and trouble doing it this way. I recommend you guys get yourself a pump. You don't have to get a big expensive pump. This little cheap pump, it might have cost me maybe $30 or something like that. All right, but it just didn't hurt me at all. All right, down here we have both the pump and the python emptying this tank out. I just want y'all to pay attention to something. I had just changed one of my pre-filters. I don't discuss this much, but let's see if you can see back there. I have what you call pre-filters. They're pre-filter sponges that I have on the intake or over the intake of each pump or each canister filter. Over this side I have two pent plaques 1200s, and on the upper tank I have two 1500 pent plaques canister filters. So look at on the right side and see how slow that flow is. That's because the pre-filter need to be changed. I want y'all to pay attention as I pull this pre-filter off. Watch how it affects the flow. All right, there you go. See, now the flow is much stronger now that I pulled that pre-filter off of it, which means that it was the pre-filter is pretty clogged up and slowing down the flow. So pre-filters are good, but just be mindful to change them when it's time. All right, so now that it's looking kind of shaky, that means it's time for me to start filling up because I'm taking too much water out to sustain the siphon on these canister filters. Pull this off so I can give this a rinse. All right, a real quick look, a quick peek at what the pre-filter sponges look like. Okay, see, this is the opening that I stick over the intake holes inside the tank. And you see, this is very porous. So I just want to catch all the big stuff from gunking up my canister filters. And also, another benefit of having these pre-filter sponges is that they harvest a lot of beneficial bacteria. You can never have too much of that. All right, and I forgot to mention, in this tank, I also keep a sponge filter to make sure I keep this water well oxygenated. I'm a stickler when it comes to water movement and keeping your tank oxygenated, because that's one of the prices that you have to pay when you keep heavily stocked tanks. Make sure you have plenty oxygenated water. So what I did was I wanted to get this water level pretty low as far as my water change is concerned. So when I start getting a weak stream coming out the outputs, spouts of the canister filters, what I did is I went on and shut the valves in the off position on both of them and unplugged them. That way, all I have to do when I'm ready, when I fill it back up, go ahead and plug them in and open the valves, and I shouldn't miss a beat. Well, family, there you have it. This tank here was the first one I did the water change on, but I changed like 80% of the water from this tank because I had to chase down the female jaguar to get her out here. I got both of them up, but she gave me the hardest time. She's very smart, very fast. She's so intelligent. She kept using these big goofy arowanas as shields. She shielded herself with them. She's so slick. But the water is still cloudy, but it cleared up real good for such a big water change. And I also remember I had rearranged everything just to get her out of here. All right, this tank here, as you can see, like I said, I make sure the water level, most people like to have the water level really high. They don't want to see the water line or whatever, and they don't want to see all those bubbles in the water. But it depends on what your priorities are. My priorities are keeping these expensive fish alive that I care for. They count on me. You can see I only have one thin bar silver dollar left, but I still have the two wide bar silver dollars. I want to let them get humongous before I put them in the predator tank. Why? Because that guy right there got a gimpy eye, as you can see. And last time I put a wide bar silver dollar in there with a gimpy eye, he was the first one that they murked. And we don't want that to happen. I want them to get humongous, so I can put him in there and he survived. But this tank is clearing up really nicely for me just doing a water change. Fish are happy and colorful swimming about. All right, down here, same thing. You see the water line, but you know, you see that I did not submerge those spouts underneath. So I make sure I got a lot of water movement, because I prefer to have well oxygenated tanks. But if you look, you see that the pink-tailed chalcias are colored up real good. The gourded rainbow fish are colored up real good. Geophagus cernunnamensis, they always colored up. It's almost time for me to put them up there in the big tank with the other guys. But I'm gonna let them hang out here for a little while longer. You see my leopard cactus plecos are moving about. So everybody's happy and colored up and not too stressed out. These guys are always colored up nice. We do a video on these guys next week. I'm not going to show you too much. Well, fish family, there you have it. Sorry if I made this a little too long. I just want to do a thorough job of showing you guys part of my routine as far as me doing maintenance and doing water changes down here, and how to optimize your time and opportunity, and save a little money in the process also. Just showing you how to make the best of it, because doing, as you know, those who have multiple tanks and especially large tanks, doing water changes on these tanks and in this fish room is different from doing water changes on, you know, a little small 55 or 20 gallon tank. You know, you have to strategize as far as doing these water changes. Well, there you have it. I'm not going to hold you much longer. Thank you for hanging out with me. Thank you if you made it all the way to the end. Those of you who have not subscribed yet, please take this opportunity to subscribe. Please just go ahead and subscribe. Hit the subscribe button, hit that notification bell so you can get notified every time I put out a video. Also, leave a comment, tell me what you think, leave a like, and we will do another video specifically about those jaguars, how they're coming along, and any suggestions that you guys have as far as the treatment and what I need to do to get those fish healthy again to put them back in a big tank. I love them, okay? Thanks again, and remember, like I said, please participate, subscribe, like, leave a comment, and share. Until next time, y'all. Y'all have a good one. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.